Mount Rainier might be Pierce County's classic mountain destination, but there's a new draw that has people seeing red at Crystal Mountain. There is a new gondola for you to ride at the resort, and the best part is, no matter your age or physical condition, just hop on at the parking lot and enjoy the 9-minute ride up 2,500 feet to the top of the mountain for a view that only skiers used to enjoy.
The scenic views are for anybody, and if you're not a hiker, hey, what better way to get to the top of the mountain than a gondola?
Pierce County Councilmember Dan Roach brought his kids along to check out the new gondola. Inside, large windows let you take in the spectacular 360-degree view.
This is awesome. I like the view.
Seen a little wildlife so far. See some pretty breathtaking views. Oh, look at this, guys. You see the whole resort down there.
Walking off the gondola, you're immediately surrounded by vast mountain views. And don't be surprised if there's snow.
I see snow!
You actually get the best view from Crystal because you can see the whole thing. And not only do you see Mount Rainier, you see four other volcanoes in the entire South Cascade Range and the Olympics. The view up here really can't be beat anywhere else.
There are lots of view decks to snap pictures and bring your appetite to savor Northwest food in the highest restaurant in the state. The gondola is just one of many affordable activities to do here. It costs $20 for adults and $8 for kids.
Most people think of Crystal Mountain as a ski area, but that's all changing now thanks to the Mount Rainier Gondola. We're open daily for summer operations and sightseeing on the gondola. Beautiful hiking trails once the snow melts out, horseback rides, disc golf course, all kinds of fun activities.
Crystal attracts the most people in the winter, about 350,000 skiers each year. But now that the gondola is running year-round, the resort hopes to draw more summertime visitors.
I'm very interested in economic drivers and what's going to be able to, you know, bring tax dollars in, obviously, so we can supply parks and recreation and other things, law enforcement. So any way we can get money into the coffers is great. You know, what better way to be able to come out and enjoy, you know, the beautiful mountains and the scenery. Here it's great. You know, you go to the top of the mountain there, you see the incredible views. You can grab a bite to eat at the restaurant. I mean, there's a lot of fun stuff to do up here.
We're located right next to Mount Rainier National Park. We're actually 6 miles from the northeast entrance to the park. So we're really geographically lucky in the sense that in the summer, naturally, there's a lot of tourists that come into this area to see the majestic Mount Rainier and visit Mount Rainier National Park. So we're hoping to capture some of those visits.
To learn more about things to see and do at Crystal Mountain year-round, visit the resort website. Now, the scenery on the way to Crystal Mountain is beautiful, but the drive can be pretty ugly, with lots of potholes, cracks, and dips. But the good news is Pierce County is about to completely replace this 6-mile stretch of 2-lane highway. The resort is on federal lands, but maintaining the road is the county's responsibility. This is the only road in and out of the resort, so it sees a lot of traffic and snow, and it hasn't gotten much maintenance since the 1960s.
Particularly when you've got the inclement weather and the ice and the snow and big drop-offs and everything else, it's important for the safety of the people using that road to be able to make sure that it's a nice smooth surface rather than hitting those potholes and cracks.
Salt and sand on the road, that deteriorates the road, and chains, and so it just takes a lot of wear and tear, and it's taken a beating over the years. And so to have a nice new road up here would really improve the access and the experience for people accessing the resort.
The work includes a new road surface and replacing the guardrail to improve driver safety.
We've got some significant culvert projects along the way that are actually fish-bearing type of culvert improvements that are going to need to be done. So there'll be a stormwater component to it. We're going to do a little lane widening, shoulder widening. If you've noticed, there's a few rock slides as you were coming up there. We're going to probably do some minor horizontal alignment shifting of the road to capture those areas to be a little safer in terms of the rock slide.
Design work is happening right now, and construction will start in 2014. The project is expected to be done in 2015. It's a little ways out, but that's when funding becomes available.
This project's going to be a little over $15 million to complete. Western Federal Lands is bringing in the lion's share of that at about $11.3 million. Other funding partners that we have are the County Road Administration Board. You've heard me mention them before. They've been good funding partners for us over the years in different projects. So they're going to bring in some RAP dollars, rural arterial preservation dollars, and they're going to bring it into, I think, the tune of about $4.2 million. So when it's all said and done, the county's contribution is only going to be $50,000, $60,000.
This project is really great for this district. Number one, you know, what an asset to be able to come out to the mountains and access the beauties that are out here. But number two, you know, if you don't have that, you're not going to be able to experience that with your family or with your friends, be able to come out and experience nature.
We hope you enjoyed learning more about Crystal Mountain and county projects happening in that area. If you have questions or comments about what you've just seen, please contact the office of Pierce County Councilmember Dan Roach. Thanks for watching.